The weekend of what I'm calling irresponsibility in Washington has led to a Monday morning sell-off on Wall Street. It was the market. The Dow was down 130 points. Now we're coming back a bit. After 10 o'clock or around 10 o'clock, coming back a bit, 93 points lower. It is Monday morning. It is July the 25th. Big day, big week. Here's the company to handle it. Look at this, everybody. David Asman, by popular demand. And by even greater popular demand, Shivani Joshi is with us, I might add. Ed Butowski, he's with us. He's going to tell us where you should put your money during this debt dilemma. He manages the money of the rich. He should know. Nicole, you got it. All right. Now, the debt worries are clearly sending gold and silver higher this morning. We had a new record for gold around 1620, I think, Shivani.
Yeah.
Is this all the debt worry? That's all it is?
Absolutely. So you're seeing investors kind of staying away from the equities markets, getting kind of concerned about what's happening here, also abroad in Europe. And so they're going to these hard material assets that you can touch and feel. Gold touched a new all-time high in overnight trading. It's come down a little bit, but it's still up more than about $14 per ounce. Silver also very much in demand today. Oil is down, interestingly enough, so you're not seeing this overall rush into commodities as a broad base, but it really is these precious metals that people are getting into today.
You know as well as I do how much interest our viewers have in silver. There's extraordinary amount of interest in silver, as much as gold, strangely enough.
Remember 1980. The same thing happened in 1980. People were even buying, melting down grandma's silver in order to get silver, and then the market crashed. These silver is even more volatile than
traveling
gold.
This weekend, I went past a couple of stores saying, "We'll bring in your silver and gold. We'll melt it down. We'll give you cash value for the silver and gold content." Those ads are back up again, right out there, all over again.
Back to the bubble.
One of the things that you said about oil being down, it's not surprising because oil moves with how we see the strength of the economy and the global demand worldwide. So this is really starting to, kind of highlight that point.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me formally introduce you to Ed Butowski, who just jumped right into the conversation there before I formally introduce the man. All right, Ed, you manage the money of the rich. I want you to tell me which area of either the stock market, the precious metals market, or any area, what takes the biggest hit starting now because of this debt mess?
Well, I don't see a massive sell-off of any kind, but what I see is a continuation of something that has been out there, and that is we're going to see, as I've said many times before, rising interest rates, right? You're also going to see the dollar dropping more. So you have two different sides. The dollar dropping is going to help large cap stocks because they export quite a bit, and so with our dollar low, they're going to start buying more products from overseas. That's good for those large cap stocks. However, you need to get out of small cap growth stocks because rising interest rates hurt small stocks more than any other sector, especially growth stocks. So, and this is the problem. A lot of people have this in their 401k plans. They've done well for the previous 2 years. It's time to make a change.
Small cap growth stocks.
Absolutely.
Okay, we don't have time, but I'd love to know some of the names. What is a small cap growth stock?
Well, you look at the Russell 2000 index, that's the smaller stocks. And a lot of people just buy those indexes. So, but in 401k plans, they're listed as small growth funds.
By the way, do you put a number on that? Is it 500 million or less in market cap?
Right. It's kind of a moving target, but it's 500 million up to about, I think, about 2 billion. But small cap growth and mid cap growth, get out of those.
Start and it's purely the interest rate play that is going to affect them. Inflation, really.
That's right. Yeah. Because interest rates are starting to rise, it's going to hurt them proportionally more. Now, conversely, get into those
big
stocks.
And the big companies have cash. They don't have to borrow that.
That's right. That's where your safe haven is right now, and you got to stay fully invested.
All right. So get out of the little guys.
That's right.
Move into the big guys.
Yes.
And one other point. We showed on our screen earlier today the 30-year Treasury.
Mm-hmm.
There was a beginning to slip. Money was slipping out of it, coming out of it.
That's right.
And as the price was going down, of course, the yield goes up.
Correct.
You think that's going to continue? That's the interest rate thing, right?
Absolutely.
Interest rates going to go up?
Without any question, interest rates are going up, and it's going to start, and it could be because of this issue, but with the debt ceiling, but overall, because of the amount of money that's going into the economy, it's going higher.
All those rich folks that you manage their money.
Right.
They should be taxed their fair share. Okay, we got that. Should they be selling their treasuries? Getting out of them?
My clients don't have them.
They don't?
No.
Why?
Because it doesn't make any sense. They're getting absolutely nothing on their money.
But they've had a wonderful rally over the past 6 months. The capital value of those bonds has gone straight up.
Well, not a lot.
Why? You can't sell treasuries to the rich these days. What's going on here?
Clients are not buying treasuries. Well, they're not buying short-term municipals. They're really, for a lot of our money, we're going into utilities right now. Really? I absolutely love utilities. You get a 4.5%, 5% dividend in some cases.
That's right.
Total return is going to be about
10. Yep.
Is Microsoft a utility?
Yes.
You know what? I know you love Microsoft.
I own it. Okay.
And you know what? I'm going to tell my clients it's time to buy Microsoft.
Are you really?
No.
No.
Well, that was fun, Ed. Are you ever going to come back on this program? Maybe. Ed Bajarski, thank you very much indeed.
Thanks, pleasure. Sir.
And now, the latest Rasmussen poll showing a growing number of voters are trusting Republicans.